sijui huko kwanza vibaya kwake. Sasa wanasema ni mimi ni mchawi, nimewaroga na mimi nililia sana 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 tena.
What's the biggest takeaway for you as a filmmaker and as a creative, because you're more than a filmmaker, from this filming process?
I mean, this was our first film. So I think just like learning on the job and just trying to figure out all the different pieces. You know, I think when you do things for the first time, I think just due to, you know, budget and not really knowing what you're doing, I think there's an automatic thing where you're just starting small. So I think for us, like, that was essentially the reason why we began how we began. And really we learned so many things, because as you say, you know, we're doing the filming, Chris is on camera, I'm on sound, and then also then doing the soundtrack, and also Chris was helping with the editing. So I just feel like because it was the first film, just trying to gather that support was a bit difficult at the beginning.
Niliona message kwa Facebook group. Cousins zangu wakaanza kusema, oh, na mzee katika familia yanaua watoto wenzake.
Tulijaribu kufanya kama community screening huko nyumbani, na tukaona watu wengine wameanza kushare out their stories about nyumbani kwao. So hii inaweza kuwa an instrument ya watu kuweza kuongea. Manake it's not people wanaweza kusema hii story out in the society. Ati mtu aje aseme, oh, kwetu nimepatikana na muona nyanyangu ni mbaya nini nini. Unajua watu wa these stories are usual in house. So ni kambe tumejifunza kuwa, yani, hii itafanya watu wanze kuongea, watu wa share out, because kuna watu wakiona film, watu wanalia, wanaanza kufeel empathy na wazee wao. So itafanya watu warege kwa wazee wao na wanze kuwapenda wazee wao na kuwatunza wazee.
I feel like when we were going on Mekati Liwamenza's journey in the first place, when we were first making this film, we learned so much about the time, like during the colonial period, where a lot of, like, the British were calling her a witch. And it was about land, it was about inheritance, it was about those things, because, and power, because the British knew that she had a lot of power to bring her people together and to fight against them. So that whole kind of, like, the whole accusations in the wrong way came early. And then now, 100 years later, we're at this same stage. On top of that, like, witchcraft is there, right? In whatever form, in whatever way. And how we dealt with it for generations and generations and generations, there's been specific ways to deal with it. So I feel that now, like in the new age, I do feel like the traditionalists, because we've been having also a lot of interview with traditionalists, they've lost their place. So you have now, essentially, you've got like the Christians, you have the Muslims, and the traditionalists are in the middle, and they're actually being squeezed. So I feel like all of our cultural traditions are going out the window, which in some ways is, I suppose, the new age. But at the same time, I feel like we're forgetting a lot of our heritage.
We had a priest who came round here and prayed for this house. He said, there's an old woman there, and she's the cause, she's the reason for all these problems.
Hii inafaa isaidie familia yetu for a start, but bado hiyo conflict bado iko pale nyumbani kwetu. So kitu muhimu ni kuwa, yani, najua itasaidia familia zingine, lakini pia inafaa ianze hapo nyumbani. So having this film imenifanya pia nika go back to my roots na kuweza kujua hizi mambo za nyumbani, mambo ya uchawi, mambo ya kiapo. So it's things ambazo zilikuwa zina happen kitambo, ni venye sisi tumekuwa influenced na hizi ma Christianity, Islam na hizi religions zengine. So hivyo ndo vitu vimetufanya tuka fade away from our roots.
Working with my husband is beautiful, it's wonderful, it's scary, it's not great, it's all those emotions all in the one. Because, you know, you're working together, you're living together, you're loving together, and it's intense, yeah. But at the same time, like, you know each other so well, and you also know how each other's work ethics, that it actually makes for a very beautiful work relationship, like making films together. As long as you just know those boundaries of how you split living family life and work life.